Peace, peace. Peace, peace. The sunset is coming down. I don't know if you can see it, but let's see. There it is. That's why this is called Sunset Chronicles. I'm a weirdo, I know. My voice is kind of going today. I've been eating a lot of starchy things. So, yeah. Okay, so today I wanted to talk about traveling alone. I can barely see myself, so sorry. Hold on. Let's see if I can. Hold on, you guys. I can barely see myself, maybe because of the sun. But anywho, today I wanted to talk about traveling alone. And this is something that I feel like should be talked about across the board, just being alone. Like, I talk about this all the time because I'm alone and I'm experiencing all of this craziness being alone. Now, don't get me wrong, I experience 90% of the time my karma is amazing, my luck is amazing, life is good. Like, I really attract beautiful beings into my world. Like, I'm blessed, you know, I really am, and I'm seeing it more and more every single day. I really am. I see it when I'm alone. That's when I see it most. The type of energy that I attract is very, very breezy, very, very lighthearted, very, very one love. I attract a lot of parents with children. I attract community. It's just weird because I attract it like one at a time. You know what I mean? So that's the positive of lone traveling. You really get to see what you attract. You really get to have complete and control over your energy and the lessons that you're learning. And it's really a beautiful thing. And you really get to choose, you know. You don't really have to compromise much. And I'm not saying compromising is bad. I actually think compromising is very good. But you really get to fine-tune what you like and what you want and choose for yourself. That's what lone traveling is all about for me. Like, it's really nice to travel alone. But one of the downsides to traveling alone is a lot of people can't understand why you're traveling alone. Oh, and you guys know me. Like, I really don't give a fuck what people think. I really don't. But it becomes a problem, and I have to start paying attention to it when they start doing ridiculous things to get my attention. You know what I mean? Like, just coming all up in my face and constantly tapping me on the shoulder and things like that. Or just following me, like, not allowing me to have that space when I need it, you know? All because I'm alone, you know? Because there's nobody there else there who's accountable for me. And so I do see a lot of the times things that'll happen to me by myself, and then I'll go to that same situation with other people, and it's like a completely different experience. And so lone traveling can be tough because people think that you need them to not everybody, but some people think that you need to be around other people in order to, like, not, like, lose your mind. And so when you really do want that alone time, there are people out there who can't understand the concept of that. And it's a little frustrating. It's a little frustrating, you know me, because I'm on a spiritual journey and I came out here by myself, and I understand that this is a lone travel. Like, I understand that. Like, I don't know how many couples I've come across since I've been out on my travels. Couples, they come out together, and by 2 months later, they're not together anymore. It's because when you left, you're vibrating at a certain frequency. When you decide to come to the tropics, you're vibrating at a certain frequency. And you think you're already at the frequency that you want to be at, but you are not. You are not at that frequency, okay? Your journey has just begun, and the universe is gonna start sending tests and people and energy, and really it's going to start coming your way once you start learning yourself. And this is the reason why people start to split up, because they realize that they're not vibrating together. And there's nothing wrong with not vibrating together. It is what it is, you know what I'm saying? In Babylon, we are programmed to think that we are supposed to be a certain way and we can't explore who we are, right? But if you really want to know who you are on this journey, you're going to have to explore yourself. And once you really start to explore yourself, the person that you attracted in Babylon might not actually have anything in common with you. And that's okay. That's okay. But I think with the Babylon programming, a lot of us aren't actually listening to what the other person is telling them. You know, like, two people, just because they get along sometimes doesn't mean that they're supposed to be together, you know? And so this is pretty much, you know, why I like to travel alone. Because until I find, you know, where I want to be, I already have a tribe. I already have a tribe of people. I already have a bunch of people who love me and are beautiful and want me to come and be where they are. Okay? I just don't particularly want to be in the Americas right now. Okay? So I'm traveling. And I'm having a beautiful time. But sometimes I want to be alone. And so that's what I've noticed. It's really hard to be a lone traveler when so many people think that you're supposed to be with somebody. And it just gets to be really annoying. And another thing is, I've talked to people about this. Like, I've totally had conversations with other lone travelers, especially lone women travelers. Lone men travelers can probably get away with it for a while. They can probably get away with it. They're just gonna have a little, like, annoying, like, boys who, like, kind of, like, mess with them or whatever and want to, like, play football or some shit. But, like, single, lone female travelers, oh man, it's really intense. I think that it's possible. I don't think it's something that should deter you from going out on this journey. I really don't. But I really wanted to talk about this because it has been a pattern. It's been a pattern in my life since I've been traveling. Like, people just want to, like, take me home and, like, lock me in a fucking room and, like, feed me, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what people want to do. But that's not what I want to do. And so it becomes crazy. But lone traveling is hard. It's hard when you have to carry your stuff. You know what I mean? Like, taking your stuff from place to place can be really hard as a lone traveler. So that's the benefits of traveling with somebody, is you always have somebody to help you with things. I'm not saying you shouldn't travel together. I think that it's whatever you want. You know, when I do these lives, I'm talking about what I want, you know? And so, yeah, lone traveler. That's pretty much all I wanted to talk about. I just wanted to talk about, like, how it can suck some, you know, like traveling alone, and people just not understanding that you want your alone time. Because everybody's partying, you know what I mean? Like, everybody's fucking partying. Like everybody's partying. Everybody. And they're going on tourist, like, things, you know? They're going to tourist things, like touristy things, like ruins and stuff like that, because they only have, like, a week or two or maybe a month to travel. So it's like a continuous, like, touristy thing. And maybe, you know, it's kind of my fault too, because I'm traveling like a tourist, you know. But my next turn is going to be like, sorry, you guys, I don't have my thing on. Peace, Alex. I don't have my comments on, so I can't even see if you guys are talking to me. But yeah. Jada says, I want to travel so bad. I'm saving money though. So soon I'll be able to travel a lot. And you're beautiful and I love you. Aw, thank you so much, Jada. I appreciate that. That was sweet. Natiri, thank you. Thank you. So are you. You're glowing. And Carlos, good morning, beautiful queen. Thank you so much.
Jeffrey
Gumola. But yeah, so I don't remember what I was saying, but I got so thrown off. See, this is why I turn off the messages, because I don't remember. I get distracted really easily from it. But anyway, I'm about to make a different turn. I'm about to go down a different path. Because what I've noticed, and I don't know if I've said this before, but like the lessons are in the patterns, you know what I mean? Like I can't remember how I phrased it, but it's basically like what you need to learn is in the patterns. Like how you're gonna figure it out is in the patterns. Like the answer, the key is in the patterns. And the patterns have been showing me the same thing over and over and over again on this journey so far. And it's because I'm making the same moves, you know? And so now I'm about to make a turn. I'm still a lone traveler, but I'm about to make a different kind of move. You know, I'm about to make a move in a direction that I'm gonna meet different types of people, you know? People who aren't just out here to party. People who are out here to actually get stuff done. People who are out here trying to actually work and build, right? I'm like up here for fucking 2 years almost. I'm up here like, I wanna meet people who wanna build. I wanna meet people who wanna get shit done. I wanna meet people, you know, like this is like me, right? But yet I'm still making the same mistakes. I'm still doing the same thing I was doing before. I haven't changed any kind of direction. And so I was like, Eureka moment, lone traveler. It's time for you to take a turn down a road that you might have not gone down 2 years ago. You want to take a turn down a road that is going to lead you to where you want to be. Okay? And that's what I'm doing. I'm taking a turn, you guys, and I'm really excited about it. So yeah, I'm going to do some organic farming, which I'm really, really excited about because I really, really, really want to learn how to farm. I've always wanted to learn how to plant. I've always wanted to learn how to farm. And I really, truly believe that I'm going to meet different types of reflections, different types of energies, because I'm choosing to actually put some love and attention into myself, which is the planet Earth, which is my body, which is sustaining me and feeding me. And this whole time up until this point, I've been just playing around. I've been playing games, y'all. Like, I've been playing fucking games. Like, that's all I've been doing. I've just been living in a fucking video board game. You know what I'm saying? A fucking charade game. I don't know. A fucking game, okay? It's been a game. And I haven't really been taking it seriously. I mean, I have been taking it seriously getting to know myself. So I think that I learned a lot about that. But in getting to know myself, I have to now apply the knowledge. And the only way I'm going to be able to apply the knowledge is if I start loving myself. And the only way to start loving myself is to actually put energy and effort into myself physically. And who am I? I am the earth. Right? We got selves and then we got a self. Our self is the planet Earth and beyond. That's the self. And into us is selves. So it's parts. It's different parts, right? And we are at a point in our existence where we're at a part of it, you know? And I am at the part of self. Recognizing self, taking care of self, nurturing self, loving self. Putting effort and practice into self. And yes, I put a lot of practice into myself, but now I'm about to go put practice into self, the earth, the planet, and I'm super excited about it. Like, I'm super excited about it because I know I'm going to meet a different type of people. I'm going to meet a type of person that thinks in a way to where they want to work on self as well. That's the type of person that I know I'm about to start meeting. Because right now, the types of people, don't get me wrong, I've ran into some beautiful people on my journey so far, like fucking amazingly beautiful. And you see the fruits of their labor just like you see the fruits of my labor, okay? Those people are beautiful. I'm not trying to knock anybody. But I just know that I'm not on that path. I'm not on that particular path, you know what I mean? Like, that path is different than mine. My path, I'm at the point in my life where I want to be building something physically with my hands, or I want to be digging in the dirt, you know. I'm not at the point in my life where I want to go out and smoke weed all day and fucking meditate and, you know, fucking, yeah. I'm just not at that point in my life anymore. And I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it, because it's a fun time. It's just not where I am. Right now, I'm at the point where I want to put my feet and my hands in the soil, and I want to be able to dig in that same soil and pull my food out and eat it. Tawanda said, I think you matured well and you definitely love yourself. That's what makes you unique. Be patient and enjoy. Good morning, beautiful. Oh, thank you so much, Tawanda. That made my evening. You guys see the sun going down? Hold on. I don't know how to... Anyway, you see it, right? The sun? Anywho, so that's pretty much what I'm embarking on. I've been applying to a ton of different farms, and I'm really, 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 really excited. I don't know if you could tell, but Tawanda said, you have to be the leader of your own path. That's you, not a follower. Go for it. Yes! Tawanda, that's great advice. I am the leader of my own path. That is such beautiful advice. Thank you so much. Like, seriously. Thank you. That's the confirmation. No, I'm just kidding. Confirmation was already there, but that was really great. Great confirmation. Seriously. So I've been applying to farms, and I'm really excited. But what I was talking about before, if you guys missed the beginning, you should go back and check it out. I was talking about peace, Trey. I was talking about being a lone traveler and how that works, and how people just think that they're gonna like control your journey because you're by yourself. And I'm not talking about people that I know. I'm talking about people in general, especially as a woman. Like, as a woman, it's quite difficult, you know, because men just feel like they are supposed to like tell you what to do. It's not like they're supposed to help you. That's not how it comes off. It's more like, I'm just gonna come and do this and you're just gonna be okay with it. No, like, I'm good. Thank you. If I need you, then cool, you know. But if I don't need you, then I'm gonna need for you to respect the fact that I'm politely saying that I don't need you right now, you know. And so, as a lone traveler, that can be difficult. But again, as a lone traveler, looking on the bright side, as a lone traveler, you really get to see what type of energy that you attract. You really, really get to see what type of energy you attract, you know, like, you really get to see it. And honestly, I can say that between 90 to 95% of the time, I attract fucking gold. Okay, I attract fucking melanin, neuromelanin. I attract beautiful, amazing individuals. Like, I'm very blessed. Very, very blessed. And I have no complaints. And it kind of sucks, because I wish that, like, I could give them more credit. But honestly, this part of my existence, this now, this avatar that I'm in, that's vibrating at a Saturn in Libra, Saturn is your lessons and responsibilities in your astrological birth chart. Saturn. The planet Saturn is your lessons and your responsibilities. And mine is in Libra. And it's exalted there. But what does that actually mean? What does exalted in Libra actually mean? Let's dig deep. All right. Exalted in Libra means this. It means that everybody has lessons in their life. Everybody. Whether you're a Saturn in Pisces, or a Saturn in Cancer, or a Saturn in Taurus, or whatever, everybody has lessons in life. And depending on what you have in that space for Saturn depends on what you need to be responsible for. So let's say you have Taurus in your Saturn. That means you need to figure out what's going on with Taurus, like literally Google traits of Taurus, and take responsibility for those traits. The more you take responsibility for those traits, the easier your lessons will be, the more fun your lessons will be, the more loving your lessons will be. But when you don't take responsibility for those traits, like let's say your Saturn is in Pisces, go look up the traits to Pisces on Google and take responsibility for those traits in Pisces, if you have a Saturn in Pisces, right?
The more you take responsibility, the easier your lessons will be, okay? But everybody across the board has relationship between person to person or person to animal, life to life. Everybody has lessons that come from relationships, right? Everybody, Pisces, has a gambit of stuff. Plus, you have lessons in relationships. Taurus has a gambit of characteristics that go with it. Plus, you have lessons in relationships. The reason why Libra and Saturn is exalted is because Libra and Saturn only gets their lessons in relationships. So everything around them is fucking perfect, except for their relationships. And that's where they get all of their lessons from. A Pisces might get their lessons from fantasy, love, drug addiction, all kinds of things, but they're also gonna get them in relationships. Taurus may get their lessons in money, earthiness, loyalty, soft inside and hard shell. Like, they might get their lessons in that, but they're also gonna get lessons in relationships. Libras only get their lessons. Libra and Saturn only gets their lessons in relationships, and that's why they're exalted. So as a Libra, in Saturn, all of my lessons are in my relationships. So Trey said, my son is exalted in Aries and I'm exalted somewhere else. Just can't remember. I think you're exalted in Venus, Trey. I think you have a Pisces in Venus. You have a Pisces in Venus, right? I'm pretty sure you have a Pisces. Or if you don't have a Pisces in Venus, then you have a Taurus in your moon. But I'm pretty sure it's Pisces and Venus. Because you have a really... No, it might be Taurus and moon. Do you remember if you're a Pisces and Venus or a Taurus and moon? Anywho. I got distracted. So I don't remember what I was saying. But what I do remember is that we were talking about Saturn and Libra. Saturn and Libra is exalted. And so I get all of my lessons in relationships. So... I don't remember what I was saying. Damn, I got distracted. Oh, yeah, it's in Pisces. Yeah, your Venus is in Pisces. Yeah, that's a really beautiful, 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 beautiful placement. Like, you guys have it super easy. So I'm trying to remember what I was saying. So I have a Saturn in Libra, which is exalted, which means all of my lessons... Oh yeah, that's what I was saying. All of my friends are beautiful. Everybody, my friends are beautiful. My life is beautiful. It's perfect. It's amazing. Like, I'm not even kidding you guys. Whatever I want, I get it. I'll tell you in just a second, Trey. Whatever I want, I get it. But the only thing that I have to teach me is my relationships. And so I do have some struggles with that. I really, really do. But it's gotten a lot better because I found my joy and I know how to like bounce back if I get frustrated, you know. I don't really let it get to me too bad, but that's where my lessons are. And when you study your astrology, you'll learn these things about yourself, you know. You will truly, truly, truly learn these things about yourself. And if you need any help, hit me up in my inbox. I'll work based off donations. I'll help you to understand your birth chart more if you have any questions. If not, you can hit me up and I'll send you a link to cafeastrology.com. You can look it up yourself. It explains everything. But if you want me to try to help you understand it, then I can do that as well for a donation. But anyway, yeah, so I'm excited about the new relationships that I have control over. So now that I know that all of my lessons come in my relationships, that is the focus that I need to have when it comes to really controlling my reality and making sure that I benefit the most from it, you know, like not the most as in other people, but just that I benefit from it, you know, that I learn my lessons. And so I think right now I've pretty much learned my lesson in this avenue, this leg of my travel, my journeys. I've learned all I need to learn. I am good and ready to move on to the next leg. Very ready. And I know then I will attract someone or people in general that are more like me. The people that I'm meeting now are like me. They're my reflections. They're just like me. But they're like me in this level of my consciousness, right? This is the level of consciousness that I am on right now. And with this turn to organic farming, I'm going to be on another leg of my growth, of my spiritual growth. And this leg is going to be more physical, where I'm literally putting my hands in the dirt, y'all. And I'm feeling myself, and I'm getting to know myself, and I'm getting to understand who I am. I'm really excited. Okay, so Trey, you were saying that, so Pisces in Venus. So Venus is the planet of love. It's the planet of feminine love, like nurturing love, like, you know, like romantic love. But it's anything that you can love. Anything, your family, your lover, your children, your pets, your job, whatever you love, your things. It's basically going to describe to you, thanks Trey, it's basically going to describe to you how you love. And Pisces is like the best at it, you know, because they're so lovable, you know, they're very like, they think about it. And so if you have a Pisces in Venus, you have it easy because it's easy for you to love. So you're going to attract a lot of beautiful people into your life. You're going to attract a lot of beautiful, loving energy into your life because you're a Pisces in Venus, and it's going to be easy for you when it comes to Venus. And you're going to be able to, yeah, have a lot. That's one of your superpowers, you know. That's a superpower, you know. Pisces in Venus is a superpower, you know. You're good at loving. You got it down, you know. But yeah, that's Pisces. And Pisces is also, Pisces is a gambit of things, you know. Pisces is a gambit of things. But when it's being expressed through Venus, it's beautiful, you know. Pisces being expressed through Mars might not be so beautiful. But Pisces being expressed through Venus is beautiful because it's a nurturing, feminine, emotional, loving planet. Unlike Mars. Mars is more like aggressive and like action and like fucking, you know what I mean? Like that is Mars. Mars is like the masculine side of love. So Pisces in Venus is the perfect placement for Pisces. I hope that answered your question, Trey. I've been eating a lot of rice and potatoes. So I got like a cough going on. But I feel great. I feel really, really amazing. Life is good. I'm going to do another live here again talking about happiness being a cure. I think I did that live the other day. I need to share it. It's a really nice one. Oh, no problem, Trey. Anytime. You know I love you. You know I love you. You're wonderful. You're one of my wonderful friends. Trey Love is one of my wonderful friends that I talk about. Like, thank you. I'm happy. I'm healthy. I'm on the beach. Can you see? I'm trying to show y'all the... I don't know how to... Oh, there we go, y'all. This is the sunset, y'all. It's behind me. It's beautiful, right? I'm gonna need for some of y'all though to come and like the people that are kind of closer to my Babylon age. I'm gonna need for you guys to start coming out here, okay? I'm gonna need for you guys to get over the fear of traveling alone and just meet me. Just meet me. Look up Woofing. WWOOFING. It's like the worldwide organization of organic farms. Yes. Thank you. I love you too, Trey. That sunset is bomb, right? But look up Woofing. And, you know, I would love to, like, woof with you. You know? Like, let's meet up at a woofing farm. Like, let's figure it out. I don't know if you know, but woofing is free, you guys. Like, you get to work on somebody's farm for, like, I don't even know. Like, 20 to 25 hours a week, and usually get like the weekends off, usually get like 2 days off in a row. You're in a beautiful location, you get free housing, and they feed you. So yeah, and you can go, there's tons of woofing that's like on beaches, there's tons of woofing that take children, that you can have a kid. Right now, I don't know if you guys follow Vibes and Flow and Rambo and Serenity, but they're woofing right now. So, yeah, it's really cool. It's just something to do until you figure out where you want to settle, you know? And it really gets you into knowing the people that live in that community. So if you really do like that community, you can build relationships with those people and maybe find something to buy, or maybe somebody will give you something, you know? You never know. You never know what happens. It's really all dependent on your thoughts and your mind, you know? Peace, peace, reflection, Denise. And so look into wolfing. It's like here in India, it's like $40 for the year. It's $40 for the year, and you get access to the wolfing database. But the only thing about wolfing is it's per like country or per region. So if you got to know that you're going to be someplace for a while, you know, or else you waste your money. But also there's workaway dot, I think it's info, workaway.info, I think it's called. If you can't find it, just hit me up and I'll send you the link. But Workaway is also really cool. Workaway is like $40 for the year too, and you get access to the database. But with Workaway, you can volunteer at hostels. So if your journey of spirituality is more like on a, like you want to be in a more hip crowd, you know, you want to go into a more hip crowd, that's okay. Workaway.com is great because they'll give you free housing and then you'll volunteer at the hostel. Sometimes they give free food too, but most of them just give free housing at Workaway. So there's wolfing and then there's Workaway, okay? And both of them are wonderful for traveling if you're traveling on a budget or if you just want to get out of the fucking States. You know what I'm saying? Like if you just want to get out of the fucking States or England or wherever, you just need a break. Or if you want to just leave forever, it's up to you. You can go to workaway.info. I think it's workaway.info. It might be workaway.net. Or you can do wolfing. And wolfing is per region. So make sure you get wolfing in whatever country you want to travel to. Like wolfing in Costa Rica, they have. Wolfing in everywhere. Everywhere, they have it. In Africa, they have it in Africa. They have it in Tanzania. They have it everywhere. So it would be nice if people, if there are some beings, some reflections out there who have the Babylon Age experience that I have, that want to really, you know, go vegan, fruitarian, and they really about this life and they really want to do it, meet up with me somewhere. We can meet up at a farm. We can work on a farm together. That would be wonderful. I would love to meet you. All right? But I'm going to get off here. If you guys missed it, just go back and rewatch it. You can subscribe if you want. You can share it if you like. If you feel like it has some good information in it, it might help some people. Please share this. But yeah, I just wanted to come on here and talk about being a lone traveler and all the options of being a lone traveler. Like, you don't have to travel with people if you don't want to. You can travel some of your time with people and some of your time without people. It's really up to you. Like, you really get a chance. But I would say come out here alone. If you have a lover, you can come with your lover. You can, but I'm telling you, I've witnessed it. People come out here with their lovers and they're not together after like a month or two. Like, they're not. They're not. They're not. I'm just letting y'all know. And it's not because they don't belong together. It's just simply because they're, once they actually get to know themselves and the other person gets to know themselves and then they try to come together, it's not the same because they don't have the same likes that they used to have when they were in Babylon. So it's really difficult. But it can work. I've known people where it's worked too. I've known some couples where it has worked. I do. I have. But anyway, I'm going to get off of here. Again, here is my sunset. It's my sunset back there. And I'm on a beautiful beach. Before I get off here, I'm going to show you guys this beach I'm on. It's really beautiful. I'm going to turn it around, okay? Oh, nice, Raven. What is that? I talked about a lot of things on this live. So what is the very thing you wanted to hear? All right, so there's the sun. It's going down. You hear that kid in the background? They sound so cute. Okay. I attract a lot of kids into my reality. A lot. I had a little girl. She was like 8 years old. She was camping in this tent that I had just for free for anybody. Her and her mom and her mom's boyfriend. And they were so cute. I really loved them. I really did. It was such a beautiful time. Such a beautiful time. But yeah, this is the beach. There's no big, you notice there's no big buildings. There's no big buildings, you guys. None. There's no big buildings at all. Like, these are literally shacks. Like, I'm not even kidding you. These are shacks. And everybody around here lives in a shack. Oh yes, Raven, you should definitely travel alone. It's a beautiful experience. You'll really attract yourself. It is beautiful here. Trey, where y'all at? Where are you and Amora at? And I'm sitting, look y'all, I'm sitting on a big ass fucking rock. Like, look how far down it is. Like, I'm really on this big ass. I had to climb up this motherfucker. Like, this shit is fucking high-ish. I was like sliding down. Oh man. Anywho, I'm gonna get off of here. All right. I love you all. I want to meet you. Trey, I want to see you soon, yo. Okay, okay. I want to see you and Amora and Amoon, possibly, very soon. Okay? I love you. I love you, Raven. And everybody else in the room. Denise, Jeffrey, Trey. Let's see. Cindy, Golden Ones, Maria. I love you all. Tawanda, Jeffrey, Carlos, Natiri. I love you all. Like, seriously. And I don't mind spending my time with people who are beautiful and respectful. I really don't. I actually really love spending my time with people like that. I'm kind of spoiled in that way. I'm picky as hell. If you're not awesomely sweet to me, then I really don't want to be around you. And I'm not trying to be funny, but like, seriously, I attract beautiful people. I'm spoiled, man. I'm spoiled. I attract beautiful people into my life. Anywho, I'm gonna get off of here. I love myself and I love you. Deuces.